Distinguished delegates, good morning. Today is the second day of the New Economy Forum. Yesterday, delegates had discussions and shared their insights on innovation, transition to the new economy, urbanization, and combating climate change. And today, we will have discussions about the global value chain and supply chain, digital economy, and international trade. We will have plenary meetings and breakout sessions and have more discussions around these topics. The new generation of information technology, including IoT, big data, AI, 5G, and blockchain, are developing rapidly and are penetrating widely into all areas. They create more and more new opportunities for development. Many believe that the digital economy is becoming a major economic modality that is after the agriculture-based economy and industry-based economy, thus driving sweeping changes in how people engage in production and live their lives. Data, just like capital and labor, has become an important factor of production. Digital technologies are being deeply integrated with traditional industries and high-tech manufacturing, and this is reshaping regional and global industry chains, and they have become an important force driving development. At the same time, protectionism, unilateralism, poses challenges to fair competition and the role of the market in allocating resources, the decisive role of the market. They have exerted major negative influences in this regard, and we have to take active steps to confront it. Digital information technology and the digital economy means that actually the governance system for cyberspace and digital economy is indispensable.
How, under the framework of the UN, we can build a universally acceptable set of rules so we could have a multilateral, democratic, transparent, safe, and efficient international system. This becomes ever more important in terms of cross-border trade, market access, and cross-border flow of data, etc. The new rules in terms of international trade and investment, for example, the above-mentioned elements, have become priorities of WTO reform. On the other hand, trade friction, high tariff, etc. These are leading to the declining of international trade, thus affecting investment decisions from the industry, and with that, it has a negative impact on the open economy of the world. All these will affect the world economy, and it will have an impact on the livelihood and employment of, for example, billions of people. That's why it deserves our attention. China is working hard to improve its homegrown innovation, developing domestic industrial sector, but also at the same time, we are stepping up international collaboration in the area of innovation. We want to be integrated into the global network of innovation, and we want to open up the market by importing more products, etc. I believe that we have to jointly stick to the principle of multilateralism while opposed to protectionism and unilateralism so that we can further the healthy development of a global economy while we work and compete at the same time. Different countries can utilize their advantages. We can learn from each other for win-win results. With that, we can create more benefits to people of all countries and also to ensure a sustainable and inclusive development of the world economy. Today's conference definitely will pay its due contribution by putting forward a lot of insights. Thank you.